city's emergency services department just got a brand new state-of-the-art radiation detector. Perfect timing as more and more tsunami debris from Japan arrive on our islands. Tammy Mori joins us now with more. Tammy.
Mori said there's been a dozen confirmed pieces of tsunami debris that has reached the shores of Hawaii and the West Coast, but none of the debris has been found to be radioactive. However, city, state, and federal agencies are using extra caution when handling the debris.
D.B. Dunlap was doing research at Makai Pier earlier this week when he found the first confirmed piece of tsunami debris to reach Hawaiian waters.
Couldn't help but notice a giant blue box floating between me and Rabbit Island.
NOAA says that blue box was a seafood bin straight from Fukushima, Japan.
Were you worried about radiation at all?
Never crossed my mind. It was only a couple of days later that somebody mentioned something about, that there had been a radiation person out here.
This past Friday, the city got a portable device that will make it quicker to test potentially dangerous marine debris.
This is a threat at this distance. You should move away.
If suspicious debris were to wash ashore, lifeguards could wear a personal protective radiological detector that would alert them to stay away if necessary. And trained experts could use this new device to find out more about the threat.
Not only do you know the amount of radiation, gamma radiation, that's being emitted from this source, but you also know the isotope.
Knowing the isotope could help identify whether it is specific to the Fukushima nuclear plant.
We're not going to come out one day and find a 10-foot wall of debris on the beach. What we are anticipating is a continual onset of debris that will be with us for a number of years.
The detector could even identify other hazardous material unrelated to the tsunami, like a chemical or biological poison, or even a bomb.
And that would help the professionals that would respond have a better idea of what they're dealing with.
Now that I understand what's going on here, I think it's going to be really, really, really useful. And I'm really glad we got one.
Now the price tag for the radiation detector was $15,000, but paid for with federal grants. Federal and state agencies have similar technology and are partnering together to recover tsunami debris. Tammy Mori, KHON2 News, Hawaii's news leader.